of boss babes and bosses out there. So in this video, I'm going to share with you a tool that can reduce your time of doing it, can lessen your effort, can lessen the potential errors when you are going to do this task. So what is that? That is a web scraping tool. Before meron akong task, kumukuha ako ng mga information, a list of mga events, kukunin ko yung title of event, registration fee, ano yung link kung saan pwede ka makapag-register, description ng event, photos, and the likes. Ginagawa ko yan siya manually. As in, nag-hire pa kami ng dalawang kasama ko kasi we have to populate a large database. Meron palang tool na makagawa niyan in just a very little time lang, and then yung machine na yung mag-read lahat ng mga kailangan ni info. So, I want to share this with you kasi maybe meron kayong mga task na ganito, nakukuha kayo ng mga info, kailangan yung scrape yung data. Pwede nyo nang hindi siya gawin manually. You can just use a tool which is for free. By the way, I will discuss first what is web scraping ba? Ano ba tong data scraping, Sue? Ito lang yung process of collecting data, especially yung mga large amount of data na it's hard for us to copy and paste manually. Pag i-copy and paste mo siya, prone to errors, time-consuming, tedious task talaga siya. There are other ways naman, like you can buy the data from the provider, no? That would be so expensive kasi you're literally buying their database. Like, i-ask mo sila if they can export all the data na need mo, tapos bibilhin mo. The third way, you can use a web scraping tool. So, ang web scraping tool, mawala talaga yung mga errors. Hindi din siya tedious ang task. You just really have to set up yung flow or yung task ng scraping tools. And by the way, you don't have to code anything sa web scraping tool na to. And again, it's for free. I will give a sample sa mga company na nangangailangan ng mga data scraper. For example, mayroong company na gustong mag-sell sa Amazon or any e-commerce platform. Tapos gusto nilang gumawa ng market research. They can scrape the data na nasa competitor nila para ma-analyze nila kung magkano ba yung mga binibenta ng competitor nila, ano ba yung mga reviews sa competitor nila, and ano yung mga popular products. You can literally get all those details sa web scraping tool. And another thing pa, if you are a social media manager or if you are a social media marketing person, this tool is also good if you want to listen to your audience. For example, you are going to scrape all the reviews sa mga products na to, or maybe technically you are just going to see kung ano yung mga posts, mga comments sa mga competitor mo for marketing analysis. This is really, really helpful talaga sa kahit anong industry. Ang i-teach ko sa inyo is to search LinkedIn, mga job posts, and isi-scrape natin doon yung mga available na mga jobs. I'm going to introduce you now the web scraping tool na sinasabi ko. Ito yung Octoparse. So, to go here, just type octoparse.com dito sa URL nyo, and ito yung lalabas sa browser nyo. And I will give you an idea kung paano natin i-extract ang data. First, we are going to enter or put the URL sa Octoparse, and then click lang natin yung target data na gusto natin i-extract. Step 3, we will run the Octoparse and export the data. And then, that's it. Now, maybe you are asking kung ano naman yung mga pwedeng ma-scrape na mga web data. Lahat ng mga links, lahat ng mga images, and mga text, pwede mo siyang ma-scrape. As long as ma-highlight mo yung text like this, and then pwede mo siyang ma-copy and paste, meaning pwede mo yan siyang ma-scrape. But, just take note of this lang ha. You're not allowed to scrape mga data na copyrighted. You should always check the terms and see if pwede pa tong ma-scrape na data or hindi. And another thing pa na kailangan yung i-remember, if that link needs na mag-login pa kayo para maka-scrape kayo ng data, then it's also a no-no because we are really avoiding mga links dito na kailangan ka pang mag-login sa account mo kasi baka maging reason na ma-ban ang account mo. If you are going to use Octoparse kasi or any web scraping tool na mag-visit ng mga profiles, like let's say, mag-visit ng 10,000 profiles in just 1 minute. That is something na hindi kaya gawin isang tao na mag-browse ka. Parang masasabi ng machine na, oops, this is not human, so I should ban this. Siguro bot lang to or ganyan, kaya binaban nila. So we don't want that to happen. That's why, if need mag-login, we should be really careful. So moving forward, if you want to try Octoparse, you can start here. Click this one, start a free trial, and then then sign up. And then, pagkatapos nyo maka-sign up, ipapa-download sa inyo tong software nila. For Mac OS, merong nakalagay dito na requirements for the OS and how to install. So, you will just have to click this one. Pero na-install ko na siya, so I don't have to do that anymore. And then, for Windows naman, you can click this one. The same, merong nakalagay na mga requirements. And then, yung how to install then. And for the pricing naman, yes, they have a very good free plan already where you can already test here kung makakatulong ba talaga si Octoparse sa business niyo. Here, unlimited pages to visit, unlimited computers to log in, and 10,000 records per export. That is already a huge amount of data. And then, 2 concurrent local run, 10 crawlers, and meron silang support. Pero, lazy support siya. Meron din silang standard plan. The amount is good, but guys, I would really, really say na meron akong great news for you kasi this coming June 15, meron silang summer sale. So, they will give more than 30% discount, guys. So, you really, really have to mark your calendar June 15 for their summer sale. So, I would highly encourage you to download it now and try this free plan and see if you like it or not. And then, avail their summer sale this coming June 15. So, with that being said, I'm going to teach you now how to scrape jobs sa LinkedIn. So first, I'm gonna click the Octoparse icon. Let's open it. Sa akin, naka-auto-login na siya. Pag naka-login na kayo, ito na yung lalabas. Ito na talaga yung dashboard ng Octoparse. Here, meron tayong new. Dito tayo maggagawa ng mga advanced mode. Pero yung basic lang yung ituturo ko sa inyo. Meron na ding mga task templates. Pwede kang mag-import ng task. Pwede ka ding mag-create ng new group. Dito naman yung dashboard. Dito malalagay lahat ng mga ginawa mo before. And then, data service, support, tools, and tutorials. Here, makikita natin na meron na tayong task template. So, meron ng template for Amazon, eBay, Booking, TripAdvisor, Instagram, and so on. And then, maraming categories dito. Ito lang yung always and popular talaga ng mga ginagamit, ng mga templates. But, we are not using a template. We are really going to create our own task. Yan yung ituturo ko sa inyo. So, let's go to LinkedIn. And then here, let's look for jobs. Here, let's type quote-unquote virtual assistant. And then state, United States. So, we already have 1,903 results. Let's put more filter. Remote lang yung hinahanap natin. So, we have 192. So, ito yung scrape natin. Itong mga jobs na to. Let's get the URL. Copy, paste natin. And then start. As you can see, nag-load na siya. And then, as what I have mentioned earlier, na dapat hindi mag-log in to avoid na ma-ban yung account. If you are going to scrape data, dapat kung pwede, hindi ka naka-log in. So, for us to close this one, we have to turn this browse on. And then, pwede na natin siyang mag-close. So, if you want to browse normally the page, you have to turn this on. Pero kung gusto mong gumawa ng action, you have to turn this one off. Now, ito yung na-load sa atin. Ang kaibahan kasi ng LinkedIn, meron siyang pattern. Check nito ha. If we are going to browse it normally, maglo-loading 1, loading 2, loading 3, loading 4, loading 5. I'm so sorry if you can hear cat ha. Loading 6. Tapos, yung pang 7, see more jobs na siya. So, the next thing that we are going to do, make sure na naka-blue to. Tapos, go to option. And then, click scroll down the page after. And then, lagay natin dito bottom page. At least 3 seconds tayong mag-wait. And then, diba 6 load before siya mag-see more na button. So, let's put dito 6 scroll. Tapos, just tap kung wala nang ma-load and then click apply. The reason why we need to put parang wait time kasi as what I have said kanina, na hindi dapat ma-detect ni LinkedIn na gumagamit lang tayo ng scraping tool. Dapat, yung activity na gagawin natin, it's like also a real human na nag-visit ng mga LinkedIn jobs. So, dapat i-delay natin yung mga activity na gagawin. For browsing, at least mag-wait tayo ng 3 seconds for that. Click apply. And then, turn off natin to. What I like about Octoparse is that meron silang auto-detect. Hindi na tayo magma-manual na mag-pick ng data na i-extract. Kasi Octoparse na yung magde-decide kung ano sa tingin niya yung mga needed natin na data sa LinkedIn jobs na nakalist. Let's just click this one, auto-detect webpage, and automatic na siya na yung gagawa ng lahat na gusto natin kukunin na data. After niya mag-detect nito, there are a lot of data na nakuha niya. Kumuha siya ng title, kumuha siya ng image. Now, dapat maklik ni Octoparse yung see more dito sa baba. So, what we're going to do, we should uncheck na this one kasi meron na tayong nilagay kanina, diba, na scroll 6 times. So, the next one is to edit this. As you can see, yung text is null. So, lagyan natin yung load more na button na see more jobs yung text. It's a button. So, yan yung makita niya. And then, let's just put na 100 clicks until na wala na siyang maload na content. So, kung wala na siyang maload na content, kahit hindi pa 100 clicks, magsistop na siya. So, just hit confirm. And then, to check, if tama yung ginawa natin, balik tayo sa baba, and then click check. Dapat mag-highlight to si Seymour. Ayun. So, nag-highlight si Seymour, meaning tama yung ginawa natin. So, create workflow. So, ito na yung workflow natin. Now, meron na tayong title. Ito yung title. Ito yung image. Tapos, base card. Ito yung full link talaga ng job description. So, each job description, meron siyang link. And then, ito din yung link ng company. Ito yung company name. And then, ito yung location. Label. Pwede natin itong tanggalin mamaya. This one as well. And the date also of posting is meron din tayo. But if ever we also want this seniority level, gusto ba nila ng expert or pwedeng entry level, employment type, kung part-time ba or full-time, anong industry and job function. If we want more, we can just click this one. Click on links to scrape the link pages. And then, dito, kunin natin tong link. Ito yung link for each job posting. So, kunin natin yung base card and then click confirm. Before we are going to get all the data here, I want you to go to option again. And instead of opening a new tab, I want you to check this load with Ajax. Load with Ajax kasi nasa gilid lang siya. Pag mag-open to new tab kasi, mag-open talaga siya ng ibang tab. Ito, nasa gilid siya. Meaning, load with Ajax tayo or Ajax. I think it's Ajax. If you are going to click here, diba, dito lang yung nage-change. Click dito yung change. So, yan yung nangyari sa Octoparse. If you are going to click, dito lang yung mag-change. So, that's why ito yung i-check. But if you are going to try it on your own, pag nag-click kayo, nag-open siya ng ibang tab, we have to check this open in a new tab. So, just click apply and then that's it. So now, ang next natin na gagawin is to click na ng mga data na gusto natin kunin dito sa loob. Pwede din natin kunin tong job description, but I really prefer the seniority level, employment, industry, and then job function. So, click this one, and then extract the text. Click this one again, extract the text element. Click, extract the text element. Click, extract the element. Ang i-click nyo ha is itong mga entry level, others, full-time. Huwag tong mga seniority level. Column name yan sila. Hindi yan sila tong mga data talaga na gusto natin kunin. So, if you are going to click this one again, try natin siguro around 10 seconds and then click apply. And then, tignan natin dito sa first natin na na-extract. Pwede natin itong i-rename if you want. Ito yung sa auto-detect. Siya lang automatic nag-populate, diba? Tapos, ito na yung ginawa natin. Manually. Data. So, ito yung mga clinic natin na entry level, ito. So, that's that. Balik tayo dito. Pwede namang wala to. Image. Hindi naman natin need tong image talaga, diba? Just delete that one. We can also rename this para mas maintindihan natin, no? URL. This one is company link. If you are going to rename it, dapat underscore. And then this one, company. And then this one, location. Ang label, pwede naman walang label talaga. If you are going to click this one, ito, apply na. Na-scrape din niya. So, pwede namang wala to na data. And then this one, itong hiring dito sa gilid, nakuha din niya. So okay lang naman na wala siya. So we can also delete that one. And then the date, kailan to na post na job post. So we don't want 1 month ago. So we can change this one to the exact date talaga na na-post. So click customized field and then exact attribute and then date and time. Yan, exact date na siya. Then here, rename din natin to. Instead of text, lagyan natin na sana lang. As long as makaintindi ka, that's good. And then this one, yung other, job function. And then the other one is employment. Again, hindi pwede na mag-space. Hindi din pwede dash. Kailangan talaga underscore kasi nag-error siya. Kasi yan yung nababasa ng machine, yung underscore. And then this one is the industries. I think we're good. Lahat ng mga nakuha natin. When you are going to click this one page, dito mo makikita lahat ng mga info na nakuha nyo. So I think we're all good. Just click save and then click run. So there's a pop-up here and then you can now run on your device. So magsa-start na yan siya mag-initialize. So, we are currently almost done now. There are already 213. If you're going to click this one, dashboard, yung makikita mo yung nirun mo. So, for the runtime as of now, 40 minutes. Kasi nga, meron tayong mga nilalagay na delay, right? Maybe I will not wait for that anymore. I will just stop this one and then let you see kung ano yung ma-download natin. Let's just stop this one. Confirm. Export. Oh, may mga duplicates na mga lumabas. So, we will just remove the duplicates para all unique data. Pwede siyang ma-export into Excel, CSV, HTML, and JSON. Or JSON. I don't know. And then, click mo lang yan siya. Okay. Rename natin to VA, US, then save. Let's try to check it. So, we already have 173. Hindi na-download lahat kasi may mga duplicates. Open folder. So, ito siya. Let's try to open that one here sa drive ko. This one. So, ito siya. Let's try to check. So, ito yung mga na-export natin. See, by using Octoparse, mas napadali. Pag tao lang nagka-copy and paste na to, hindi kaya na 1 hour na 173 yung makuha na data. So, ayan, ganoon lang kasimple. Hopefully, naka-follow kayo sa tutorial and intindihan nyo bakit ito yung clinic ko, bakit ganito yung delay, yung mga ganoon. If hindi nyo naintindihan, you can comment below and ask me kung paano siya or kung meron kayong gustong website or links na gusto ipaparse. Like, for example, Sui, can you please make a tutorial how to scrape information sa Amazon or Instagram or Twitter or kung anong link man yan? Just comment below, baka magawa natin yan ng content. And yeah, if you really want to try this, download it now. And then don't forget na merong summer sale ang Octoparse this June 15 with more than 30% discount. So mark your calendar. And yeah, if you like more content like this, don't forget to join our group. I'm ready to boss up Paper Ksui. And like our Facebook page. And follow us on our Instagram accounts at Briksui and at BossUpPH. So yeah, hope to see you guys on my next one. Bye!